Cricbuzz Centerstage Day 2 at Edgbaston of this Ashes clash between England and Australia. Adam Collins and former England captain Michael Vaughan with me here on a day where England gutted it out. You've been wanting to see England do this for a long time, Michael.
That is the best day's test match batting I've seen from the England side. They've crashed balls to all parts in Test cricket. They've played a risky game. That is the best I've seen them for many years. And you know what? It's just reminded me, in Test cricket, when you get the batting out, you've got to put a shift in. Mm. And Rory Burns put a shift in. The best compliment I can give him is that Alastair Cook, our leading scorer of all time in Test match cricket, that's an Alastair Cook style innings. Rory Burns has just played like Alastair Cook. The foundation's set. And also, 2 days of Test cricket, let's be honest, the celebration of a little bit of quirkiness. You look at Steve Smith's technique all over the place, you know, but watches the ball, plays with great awareness of the situation, of what's required on that occasion. Rory Burns did a similar thing. His bat's coming from all angles. But what he did in this innings compared to what we saw against Ireland was his hands were tighter. A little bit tighter to the body. He knew where his off stump was. He let the ball go through and he just made them bowl to him. That clip off the hip, just little punches. All right, he had a bit of fortune playing and missing, but you know, that's Test match cricket. That was a rival back. England can play Test match cricket the proper way.
You talked about Alastair Cook. Burns has now got one more Ashes 100 in England than Cook does. Burns has done it on the first time of asking. Cook never made 100 in this country. So not that it means anything. Of course, Alastair Cook, one of the all-time greats of the sport. But Burns did show grit. As you say, he did struggle at different periods through the day. The Australian bowlers were right on top, but he never gave it away up here.
No, and I think that's, you know, to play Test match cricket, you've got to be tough up top, because when you're facing the likes of Siddle, Cummins, Pattinson, Nathan Lyon, spinning it, beating the outside edge, it's the next ball. And what I saw today is that Rory Burns parks that. You know, if he plays an iffy shot or one goes through the slips or he gets a play and miss, it's the next ball. Yeah. He was back on it, into his groove, into his rhythm, realising what was on, what wasn't. You know, I think Test match cricket is all about that. You can have all the shots, but it's what shots you require to play on that given day against a given bowler on a different pitch. It might be different tomorrow. You might require a different shot or two, but it's reading the situation, and England read the situation. That's hard work, that, to bat that amount of time against that attack. And I thought Australia bowled pretty well. You know, I think the Aussies have been in the room thinking maybe could have gone half a yard fuller in the morning, maybe a little bit fuller with a second new ball. But, you know, I think they bowled pretty well. And to have an opening batsman bat the whole day in Test match cricket, wow, we're celebrating.
One for the purists. 267 for 4 is a score at the close. But the balance of the Australian attack was such a talking point before this match and this series. Peter Siddle coming in instead of Mitchell Starc. For my way of seeing it, Siddle played a crucial role today in tying up one end, in bowling one side of the pitch, which meant that Pattinson could bowl aggressively. Cummins, not his best day, but he had that freedom as well.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think the selection's been wrong. You know, you're looking at 44 runs yesterday from Peter Siddle. Where would Australia be without those runs? So you've got to look at the whole combination of what Siddle brings in English conditions. I think the selection's absolutely fine. The Aussies have played all right. You know, you're looking at the review. Yeah. You know, Rory Burns should have been back in the hutch early to Nathan Lyon. Who knows how the game would have panned out if that decision would have gone the way of the Australians. But, you know, I think for 2 days, Test match cricket is a celebration. The Australians yesterday, Steve Smith, remarkable. Rory Burns today. I wouldn't say it's as an incredible innings as we saw Smith played, but in the circumstance of what I saw Rory Burns last week against Ireland, getting out, you know, wide of off stump, just fending at the deliveries, to come this week and bat the whole day and get his first test century against a quality attack under this amount of pressure, it shows that he's made of something. Whoever he's worked with, and I kind of know he's worked, I think it's Alex Stewart and his brother at the Oval, Neil Stewart, they've worked wonders, because it's nothing like a batsman. If you can trust your technique and you know your technique's in decent form and you know you're kind of sinking and you're moving all right, you can play, you can watch the ball and you can bat long periods of time. There's nothing worse as a batsman when you know something's not quite right. And I reckon what we saw from Rory Burns, and probably in county cricket this year when he's batted, he's not been quite right. So what has he done? He's gone back to his old coach and he'd have hit thousands of balls over the course of the last week. He's arrived here with the confidence that his technique was in tighter order than it was a week ago. He deserves all the credit.
A couple of quirky bits today. The change of ball. It wasn't swinging at all. There was a change of ball at about the 60 over mark and suddenly it was going around corners. Two wickets, two pretty handy ones as well. Denley, courtesy of Pattinson. Then Butler. We know how destructive Butler has been in Test cricket in the last 12 months. Cummins sorts him out. And then we also saw Matthew Wade bowl. I mean, we've seen Matthew Wade bowl a lot in the nets and he has bowled in Test cricket and first class cricket before, but it kind of, you had to look twice, didn't you?
I'm going to state now, I don't think we'll see Matthew Wade bowl again in Test match cricket. I think his bowling career, it's gone. He's not bowling again. The change of ball, look, England tried to change the ball yesterday afternoon. It happens. They got a nice ball in the hand, the Aussies, and it worked. Pattinson got that ball to kind of just tail back into Joe Denley. Cummings gets the ball that just holds in the surface to Joss Butler. Good catch from Cameron Bancroft. Test cricket, ball's changed. You've just got to bowl well and take your chances, and that's what Australia did in that spell. But I thought Ben Stokes, he strolled out there. He kind of just floated out to the wicket, and it was like, why are you playing so well? You hadn't hit a red ball for months. Yeah, he just went boom. Balanced, confident, great forward defence, lovely flicks, nice drives down the ground. It's a prominent position for England, because if they come out and play with the same ethic of hard work and discipline, and the two that will be celebrating most in that room tonight will be Stuart Broad, Chris Wokes. They've had a day in the shed. Two England bowlers who bowled the heart out yesterday. Jimmy Anderson's gone down. They had a day drinking tea in the shed, watching a player, an opening batsman like Alastair Cook, go out and play the whole day against Australia. They'll be the ones that'll be celebrating tonight. They've rested.
Speaking of Stuart Broad, he did sort of hint that Jimmy Anderson may bowl in the second innings. Who knows? All the ducks and drakes.
Left arm spinner, and he can bowl a little bit of left arm tweet. He ain't bowling in this game. Unfortunately, he's certainly got a massive issue with that calf. And you know what England have done now, because they've batted so well today again, you've got to put the yards in Test cricket, you've got to put shifts in. They put a shift in. What does that give them? It gives them a chance for Moeen Ali to hold an end, and he should be able to with his team. What would the lead be, 100? You would hope from this position, from an English perspective, Moeen Ali should be able to hold an end, and three seamers can rotate from the other end. So England are in a perfect position, having had a fantastic day of hard work.
They trail by 17. If they can lead by 100, it'll, of course, negate Australia's benefit of bowling fourth on this wicket. So fascinating day of Test cricket. It always is between these nations. Adam Collins, Michael Vaughan. This is Crick Buzz, Centre Stage at Edgbaston. We'll talk to you tomorrow.